said to Joshua, do not fear and do not be dismayed. Take all the fighting men with you. And Uriah spoke to Ai, see, I have given into your hand the king of Ai, and his people, his city, and his land. And you shall do to Ai and his king as you did to Jericho and his king. Only his spoil and his livestock you shall take as a plunder for yourself. Lay on embassy against the city beyond it. So Joshua and all the fighting men arose to go to Ai. And Joshua chose 30,000 mighty men of valor and sent them out by night. And he commanded them, behold, you shall lie in embassy against the city behind it. And do not go very far from the city, but all of you remain ready.
And I endured that the people who are with me will approach the city. And when they come out against us, just as before, we shall flee before them. And they will come out after us, until we have drawn them away from the city, or they will say, they are fleeing from us, just as before, so we will flee before them. Then you shall rise up from the ambush and seize the city, for the Lord your God will give it into your hand. And as soon as you have taken the city, you shall set the city on fire. You shall do according to the word the Lord. See, I have commanded you.
So Joshua said to them out, and they went to the place of ambush, and lay between Bethel and Ai, the west of Ai. But Joshua spent that night among the people. Joshua rose early in the morning and mustered the people and went out. He and the elders of Israel bore the people to Ai. And all the fighting men who were with him went up and drove her before the city and encamped on the north side of Ai, with a divide between them and Ai. He took about 5,000 men and set them in ambush between Bethel and Ai, to the west of the city.
Even up to heaven, and they have no power the previous way or what. For
destroyed the city Israel took as their plan according to the word of the Lord that he commanded Joshua. So Joshua burned Ai and made it forever a heap of ruins as it is to this day. And he had a king of Ai that day and the evening. And at sunset, Joshua commanded that they took his body down from the peak and threw it at the entrance of the gate of the city and raised over it the great heap of the stones which stands there to this day. At the same time, Joshua built an altar to the Lord, the God of Israel, on Mount Ebal, just as Moses, the servant of the Lord, had commanded the people of Israel, as it is written in the book of the law of Moses, an altar of uncut stones, upon which no man has wielded an iron tool, and they offered on it burnt offering to the Lord, and sacrificed his offering. And there, in the presence of the people of Israel, he wrote on the stones a copy of the law of Moses, which he had written.
Yesterday we saw the story of Ai in this city, the Israelites. They were defeated. They couldn't conquer this city, then they are defeated. Maybe most of them very disappointed. They thought this is easy to conquer and own, but it seems, although it seems easy to conquer, it was not easy without God's help and God's grace. So they are defeated from this city, Ai. Actually, we, most of us, experience after we did mistake, we are so disappointed and frustrated and we are so afraid of the future. But today, in chapter 8, we see that they conquer this city Ai. So God promised victory. Very simple. They conquered the city Ai by what? If you read verse 1 to 2, but God promised. The Lord said to Joshua, do not fear. Do not be dismayed. Take all the fighting men with you and arise, go to Ai. See, I have given into your hand the king, people, city, land. So you shall do to Ai and his king as you did to Jericho. So God says, I have given this land into your hand. This city belongs to your hand. So you just do what I command. So God promised, like before, to conquer Jericho. And then what they have to do is obey God's word by trusting His promise. Very simple. God promised, they obey by trusting God's word. So there is also some strategy to conquer this land. But Joshua, he take how many fighting men? 30,000 men. In chapter 7, how many people he took? 2 or 3,000. But now very different. 30,000 men. And then some people, they just flee, escaping from the soldier of Ai. Then all the soldiers of Ai follow his people. Then at the back of this Ai, the people, Israel attacked. This is a strategy to conquer this land. And actually they trust God, then they obey what God commands. Very simple. God promise, then trust, obey. You know, actually God promised you enter Canaan. People of Israel, they can enter Canaan. And God promised this land will be your land and your inheritance. But we learn very simple truth. Even though God promised something to his people, if you read the Bible, you find a lot of God's promise. Right? This is all the God's promise. Even though God promised a lot of blessing to his people, we need obedience. We need obedience. Even though God promised blessing and a lot of good things, to enjoy God's promise and blessing, we need obedience. Obedience comes from faith, from the trust. Then after they conquer this city, Ai, if you read the Bible, verse 30 to 35, Joshua and God, actually Joshua, he renewed the covenant. If you see the Bible, verse 30 to 35, Joshua built an altar to the Lord, the God of Israel, on mountain Abel. Do you remember Abel? In Deuteronomy chapter 27-28, two mountains, Abel and Gerizim. Verse 33. Levitical priests who carried the ark of the covenant of the Lord, half of them came from the mountain Gerizim, and half of them came from the mountain Abel. Same. In Deuteronomy 27:28, there is how they spend. But in Deuteronomy, the Moses, he speak about God's word. Actually, law of God. But now, Joshua, he followed the same way. He made the altar to the Lord, and he offered burnt offering, verse 31, burnt offering, and sacrificed peace offering. Then he took the stone and he wrote all the law of God. Then he read all law of God to the people of Israel. So actually renewing the covenant is very important, because the people of Israel, actually they broke the covenant. The people of Israel, they should do obey God's word. Yesterday we saw that. What's the problem of Israel? What is the main problem? Idolatry. In chapter 7, the God said, you, verse 15, and he who is taken with the devoted things shall be burned with fire, he and all that he has, because he has transgressed, what? The covenant of the Lord. I told you already what the meaning of this, transgress the covenant. What is that? Yesterday, Deuteronomy 17. Idolatry. Actually, this idolatry is from covetousness. And Colossians 3:5 says, covetousness is what? Self loving ourselves and trusting ourselves is idol. Because of covetousness, covetousness is what? We are not satisfied. We are not satisfied in the God's promise, and we trust ourselves, we want to satisfy ourselves. That's the idolatry. Actually, they need only God's promise. God's promise is enough for people of Israel, but they are not satisfied. They have covetousness, like Achan. But Achan's sin is the sin of Israel. Right? Yes, the people. Right? Not only Achan's sin, whole congregation's sin is covetousness. That's the idolatry. So that's why, because of idolatry, they transgress covenants. The covenant was like a broken. They must keep this word of God, all the local birthday is open, and because that's why they need renewing covenant. Covenant, making covenant is like a renewing fellowship with God, relationship with God. Your covenant means relation. So they offer burnt offering and peace offering. You know, this is for making relationship with God. So Joshua, he knew that most important thing is not just having victory. What they want to do and what they get from the battle, that's not important thing. But Joshua, he realized that covenant, relationship with God, is the most important value. So he read all the word of God, verse 34. And afterward he read what? All the words of the Lord, blessing and curse, blessing and curse. All the word of God, all. Maybe after they had the victory, they want to hear only the blessing. They want to hear only word of God about blessing. Blessing. But all the law means blessing and curse as well, according to what? Obedience and disobedience. So Joshua and people of God, they should remember blessing, curse, life, and death. Blessing and curse, life and death, and success and fail depend on obedience to all the word of God. You know this, but this is not very special. God always said, trust, obey, and blessing. You disobey, curse, or you die, and not successful. This is very clear. If you obey me, obey my word, you are blessed, and you get life. And if you disobey my word, curse, not successful, die. You know, Deuteronomy, we learn about Deuteronomy. In Deuteronomy, Moses, before he died, he emphasized only one thing. What's that? Deuteronomy? Lord. Only one thing. Before he died, he preached again, you people of God, you must remember the grace of God. Then because of the grace of God, you obey God's word. If you obey, you are so blessed. If you disobey, you are not blessed. You die and destruction. Very simple. He emphasized, you obey word of God, all the word of God. And all the people of God, they must say, Amen, 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 Amen. They already heard Israel, the people of Israel. And we know also, obey, blessing, disobey, curse, this is life. life, this is bad, you know. But Israel, you just imagine the situation of Israel. This is very different, quite different. Knowing some knowledge with your intellect, but knowing some knowledge by your experience and feeling and some situation, this is very quite different. You know, Israel, they already learn obey, blessing, disobedience, curse, but the experience, events, what's that? In Jericho, they experience Jericho like our chapter 6. And today chapter 8. They experience Jericho AI conquered by God. They obey and trust God. But like chapter 7, they experience disobey is not good and it brings the result. They are not successful in their work. You know, they experience his knowledge from the war. Chapter 6, Jericho, chapter 8, today chapter 8, AI, they conquer this land because they follow, obey. But in chapter 7, they experience not successful because of disobedience. Also speak to us. We must learn some instruction. We learn a lot of things in our life from the success and victory, but also from the failure, mistake. Actually, God's purpose is not only curse his people, he really wants to bless his people. And he can turn our situation from the curse to the blessing and from the death to the life. Actually, we sometimes commit the sin, but like John, 1 John chapter 1, verse 9, even though we commit the sin, God is faithful that we confess our sin, that he surely forgive our sin. Failure, mistake is also one of good education, instruction for God's people. We must turn back to God from the disobedience. If we confess our sin, means confessing our sin, repenting our sin is not only speaking and talking. Martin Luther says, life of all believers is repentance. Repentance is not only talking and going to the some priest and confessing. Repentance is not only confessing. Turn back from the sin and turn to God. If we confess our sin, repent our sin honestly, surely faithful to forgive our sin, and he really bless and he give us his life. Let's pray. Father, we confess we do sing. Well, and we sometimes transgress the covenant that you promised to us, like Israel. But in you and revive and restore relations with you, by your grace in Christ, our heart is always inclined to the sin. But from the new birth and second birth, regeneration, you give us new heart, new desire to follow you and to obey you. We need new heart, regenerated heart, to obey you by the Holy Spirit. Jesus said, unless we are born again, we cannot enter your kingdom. We cannot see your kingdom. Which means we all born again from above. From your grace alone. Father, you instruct us continually. Not only from the success, but from the failure and mistake. We know your purpose and your aim for your people is blessing, not curse. Life, not death. Or we want to enjoy your blessings and your goodness by the obedience, trusting your character and your grace. You bless us, Lord, this morning. You deserve all the praises from our thanksgiving and obedience all the day long. Then, before we sleep tonight, we might praise your goodness and praise your amazing instruction for our life and blessing. In Jesus' name I pray.
Amen.